the ambition that you have for the thing that's like this magical thing is going to rescue you from this other thing that you don't want to experience. But the thing that you don't want to experience can be transformed through your graph, through your practice of being grateful for what you have and receiving, as opposed to thinking that some outer thing is going to rescue you. Because let's imagine, let's use the example of a retreat center. You know that you're meant to do a retreat center. Amazing. You call a place. What do you have to do? You have to, this is Earth, baby. You have to call people. You have to deal with people. You're going to have to deal with contractors. It's going to be a process. Everything on your spiritual journey is climbing a mountain. You're going to get to the top of the mountain. Then you're going to want to climb another one. Then you're going to be at the bottom of the mountain. Then you have to do all the shit to get up to the top of the mountain. Then you'll be like, the initiations don't end, right? The work doesn't end. The suffering doesn't end. The way that we are, who we are, how we be amidst all the earth stuff is the yogic way out of samsara, of the suffering. It's the only option. The only option is finding inner peace. Earth is earth. Maybe you'll get a great idea. I want to build a ski lodge. Things will all fall into place. You'll build the ski lodge.
I'm gonna build a ski lodge, like a ski. And you saying it's ridiculous.
Why? You thought
Yes, today.
that? I'm good. I'm good at
You
that. This is
are.
why I make the money doing this. This is why I do this for a living. Right. So you're gonna do it, and then it goes well. Somebody, you get a partner, they're happy, you do it, you're fulfilled, it happens. But these things that happen, to be honest with you don't anything that's magical. Like even our meeting, anything that happens happens because it happens and it's the kind of destined. It doesn't, you don't create and go do, you don't like make magic happen. Magic always comes to us. How did you know, like when you met your husband, did you like create that? It happened. Life happens. You, and that's why I have a big thing about trusting life. And I've been initiated by like my own. I'm you. You were like, wow, you don't judge me. And I'm like, because I understand everything that your brain does. I get it. Like, I get what it is to have hardcore trauma. I get what it is to like be really willful and intelligent and sometimes too intelligent for your own good that you get in your own way. I get what it is to be like an assertive, strong, balanced and masculine and feminine woman in this world who's on a spiritual journey. Like I understand all of those things. And the best thing that we can do is be kind to ourselves, stop judging ourselves, and not put the pressure. So being good here, from here to here, your head to your heart, and like your heart to the infinite, if you can do that and be kind to your family and the people around you, you're gonna live that life that you're looking for.